All right, what's going on, everyone? So I wanted to make this video to kind of build on one of my previous videos that I made and also build on some of the things I've spoken about before. I wanted to talk about how to turn a one-time customer into a long-time customer and a repeat customer and a customer that obviously continues to do business with you. Because when it comes down to it, the hardest customers to always get are brand new customers, right? Customers that don't know about your brand, your business, or anything like that, because obviously there's no trust, there's no likability yet, and obviously they're just getting to know you. And so one of the things I want to kind of go over that you guys should implement into your business is to really nurture all of the leads, prospects, and even customers that you interact with within your store and your business, and how to really maximize that for the long game that you're obviously playing this in. Some of my previous videos, I mentioned how the ultimate goal isn't to always drop ship other people's products, but until later on have your own e-commerce product. But one of the ways you can start building a customer base is obviously through drop shipping. And so one of the things you want to do is nurture all of the customers you're coming in contact with. And there's a few different ways you guys can do that. I'm going to go over how you can do it utilizing email marketing. A couple different things. When it comes to email marketing, one of the things that people do is kind of misunderstand how to utilize it effectively. Everybody thinks about email marketing as like one of these things that you just do to send promotional emails to your customers to get them to buy, and that's it. Now, don't get me wrong, of course, you want to utilize email marketing as another channel to market to your customers, but to really utilize and maximize the efficiency of your email marketing within your business is to not only try to sell your customers through emails, but to really focus on building relationships instead. One of the things we do is really focus on having different email automations based on different actions that people take within our e-commerce business. And honestly, it works out like a charm. Like, we have a ton of different automations, and these emails, like, they do take some work up front to set up, but in the long run, they end up being really effective and generating you extra revenue that you would have never have generated if you didn't have these emails in place. If I'm looking over, I'm just covering to make sure I go over everything that I kind of outlined for you guys here in this video. One of the first things is when it comes to maintaining a relationship with all new customers that are visiting your store, you know, visiting your business, buying from you, not buying from you, is you want to focus on providing value to these customers, right? And for example, you're going to have people that visit your store, your website, that come in and they don't buy anything. They show interest, they look around, maybe they add a product to their cart, maybe they sign up for your newsletter, but they don't actually end up buying. That's a specific kind of customer, right? That's just someone that obviously showed interest in your product or services. It's just not someone that purchased from you just yet. And that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. You want to be able to address people that are obviously like brand new to your business and interacting with you. You want to address people that have already interacted with you, people that have purchased from you. And you also want to address people that have purchased from you more than once and have continued to do business with you. And you want to have it set up where it's scenario by scenario. For example, what I mean by that is you want the communication between you and the customer that hasn't purchased anything from your store to be completely different than the communication between you and someone who has purchased from you more than once, because obviously they're two different kinds of people. You know, one of the main problems also that people have in the e-commerce space that I usually get asked about is, hey, I'm driving a ton of traffic, I'm getting a ton of ads to carts, I'm getting a ton of leads, but I'm not getting any conversions, right? I'm getting all these visitors coming to my store and into my business, but no conversions. There's probably a lot of things you can change within, like optimizing your product pages, maybe the product, maybe the ads. That's a factor of multiple things. But one of the things you want to focus on, and one of the things you want to avoid having to kind of keep that barrier between people actually buying from you, is the amount of value you're providing to the people that are interacting with your store. One of the things that we do is we have what we call a welcome series or a new customer series email automations in place that we actually utilize for people that just show interest in our store, either through opting into our newsletter, opting in for a discount, but still have not purchased any products yet, or abandoned carts. For brand new people that have just interacted with our store, our main focus isn't to try to sell these customers anything while we're contacting them, right? When we're reaching out to them or when we're communicating with these customers. And you guys should be communicating with your customers, because in reality, it takes more than one interaction to actually get someone to like you and trust you and then end up buying from you. So we focus on all the emails that are going out to them before, for specific customers that have not purchased yet, are all value-based. We're sending out all kinds of emails. We're sending out educational emails, customer reviews, different kinds of content based on around the products and services that we're selling. And that has worked really well because when a customer comes to visit your website and they opt in, for example, for like a newsletter, they're expecting to get all these different like sales emails. And like usually what happens is they'll automatically opt out. And obviously then the communication stops. And that's what you don't want, because once the communication stops, well, that's one less possible avenue of revenue. We make sure to try to provide as much value as we can to all prospects and leads that have not purchased from us just yet. Because again, our goal is to really build that relationship, get them to like us and trust us to then buy. So that's just a quick example for brand new customers or brand new leads, people that have just visited our website. And some of the ways you guys can do that, if you're thinking, well, like how do I come up with the content or where do I get the value to send to them? Well, you can focus on creating your own kind of content. Like you can set up like a blog section of in your store, and it doesn't have to even be visible. You can just have it as somewhere where people can click on an email and then lead them back to your store. Okay, the main idea is to be able to have content available, and it doesn't always have to be your content. You can find things to share online. For example, if you're selling, let's say you're in the home cooking niche and you find cooking products, well, one of the things you can do is include like a guide of recipes to make with, you know, a specific kind of product or whatever your ideal demographic is. But it doesn't have to be all be your content. You can simply share content that other people have posted online, give them credit for it, but then use that content to provide value to your customers. And that's what we do. We do a mixture of that, and we also do a mixture of creating our own content and also using like user generated content, which is like content made from our like customers and experiences that we've had within our business. So for abandoned cart, that one is actually, it's pretty basic, but there's still levels to it. For abandoned carts, we specifically focus on reminding the customer that, hey, you already showed interest in this product, and I understand that when you saw it, it maybe wasn't the best time for you to check out because obviously life happens, maybe you were doing something, but I wanted to send this email to remind you, right? Those are usually the main purposes of sending out those emails. And you know, like we do mix in a little bit of content in between. That way it's not just like sale email, but we also leverage things like discounts. And my business partner and I, we actually put together an e-com incubator where we actually go over showing you guys how you can not only set up things like email automations and different forms of communications with your customers and leads, but we focus on showing you all of the different methods of advertising within your e-commerce business. And you guys can actually check it out. There's gonna be a link down below this video where you guys can check it out, get a completely free trial to it. And obviously in the inside, you guys will get to learn a lot more about it. But so that was for abandoned carts, right? Obviously abandoned carts are super important because there's a specific level of between the audiences that are brand new and abandoned carts. Obviously someone that came in, added a product to their cart and didn't purchase, well, that's someone that's obviously more valuable than someone that has only opted into a newsletter or gotten a discount. And so obviously you wanna make sure you set those up, those email automations up right, where you're still offering some value and you're also offering some incentive for them to come back and actually purchase the product that they already showed interest in. And you can do that with different things like discounts, offer free shipping on the product, or you know, just try different methods. But that's what we focus on doing within our abandoned cart email automations, for example. Now, when it comes to working with people that have already purchased from you, these are obviously super valuable because you have already broken that barrier and that you've already gained that like and that trust from that customer. And so what you wanna do for specifically customers that have already purchased from you is you wanna have specific emails in place and a specific automation to show appreciation to the customer for them buying from you, right? Showing them, hey, I appreciate you guys doing business with us. Thank you guys so much, right? That's a simple email that's not hard to put together and it literally just has to come from you. And I'm telling you guys, it goes a long way. Because from there, what you do is once you start showing appreciation, what you then do is you also start to ask them for feedback, right? You ask them if their product has already came in the mail, then you ask for feedback on the product, how they're liking the product or service that they actually got from you. And then there's two main benefits from this. Obviously, it shows a customer that you care about them. And second, you can also use that and the feedback from that customer for that product as content to send out to other potential prospects, right? People that haven't purchased just yet. One of the things we do in one of the emails that works really well for us is having a testimonial email where it's just different testimonials from different customers that are interacting with our store and our website. And so that's one of the things that works pretty well for us. And that's the benefit of having these different emails in place is because they have more than one purpose for them, right? In that same email automation, where obviously you're showing appreciation and you're asking for customer feedback and things like that, well, after you've done these things and you've provided value to the customer and you've shown them that you care, you can then remarket and resell to these customers other products and services that you have available. But this will only be effective if you do these things first. Because for example, after a customer buys from you once, and the first thing you do right after is try to just sell them another product immediately, rather than checking in on them or providing them any value. Or same thing with like a new client, a new lead that just opted in for a newsletter or opted in for like a discount. If you try to sell these people first thing, well, what they're gonna do again is opt out of your email list, and you're never gonna be able to come in contact with these people again. And the main purpose of having value emails, content, all these different things is to communicate with your customers and keep them always engaged. Because once you have a customer that engages with your business and keeps open line of communication, like they always open up your emails and they always give you feedback on your products, they comment on your social media, all these different things. Well, these are people that will continue to do so. These are customers that will continue to work with your business and buy from you. And so you want to make sure you nurture all of these clients and customers and leads that you have coming in, because in the long run, these are the people that will keep your business running. Now, obviously, focus on your social media. Obviously, if you guys are not building your brands through your social media, that's something you guys want to do. When it comes to buying things online, something that's super important is, you know, leveraging your social media. You know that your customers are gonna go and check to see, you know, your social media pages. They're gonna probably message you on social media. They're gonna comment on your pictures, things like that. And so showing that you interact in your social media is super powerful, because that's another form of communication with your customers now. If they can see that you're active on social media, they'll feel a lot more comfortable going in there and reaching out, which once other people start seeing that, you know, you're responding to your customers and leads and prospects and questions, well, that's gonna make them also feel more comfortable buying from you and interacting with you and your business. So you wanna make sure that you guys are implementing all these different things, because in the long run, these are the things and the building blocks that go into having a successful e-commerce business. Now, obviously, some of you guys may just be dropshipping, but these things can go a long way. Because again, later on, some of you guys, again, have heard me talk about having your own product and things like that. Well, if you've already been doing this from the beginning, later on, once you have your own product, it's gonna be a lot easier for you to get people to buy from you, because you're gonna have a customer list, you're gonna have people interacting with you, people that like to work with you and your brand, and so it's gonna be a lot easier. That's one of the things for sure you wanna do. Another thing you wanna do is focus on not ending the relationship or the interactions with your customers once the sale is made. One of the biggest lessons I got from door to door is, like, literally once you get a customer to say yes, that's actually when the sale starts. Most people think that once a customer buys, it's like it's a done deal, like they bought and like that's it. But in reality, again, like, the purpose should be to provide value, nurture all the customers to then get repeat customers. Because again, who wouldn't want a customer that buys from them more than once? That's how Amazon became one of the biggest, obviously a $1 trillion company in this industry, because almost all their customers, and even me, I consistently buy from Amazon over and over and over again. And it's because of the things they do, right? The service they provide, how they interact with me through emails, everything that they do is just really excellent, right? If I have any problems, they immediately respond. You can call them up, chat box, all these different things. And so that's another thing. You also want to see how you can have almost immediate support. One of the things we realized, and we were actually testing, is having the live chat box feature on our store and not having it. And we also did a test where we would have this app running called Lucky Orange. And we would realize that people would actually, when we didn't have the chat box, obviously people, you know, they would be hesitant to ask any questions. And sometimes they would be turned, I mean, there was no exact way to narrow down what would turn them off from buying. But we realized that when we had the chat box installed, a lot more people interacted with the chat box, and they got simple questions answered that then led to them making the purchase right away. And I'm confident that for those of you guys that don't use chat box, and even when we didn't use the chat box feature, we had customers that came in and I'm sure they had questions, but because they didn't want to email and then wait to get a response, or, you know, go to the social media pages and mail an email and get or DM and have to wait to get a response, they decided to just, you know, not buy the product. Sometimes it's as simple as like one simple thing, just keeping a customer back from buying from you, and having a live chat box feature installed in your store, obviously if you can, will help out a ton. But also having great customer service can also be really helpful, because again, same thing, we've noticed a ton of customers that email in simple questions about the products and services we have to offer, and some people, as soon as we respond to the questions they have available, we notice that they buy right away. And that was literally just the one thing keeping them back from buying. So that's just one thing. I don't want to make this too long of a video. That was pretty much it. If you guys learned anything at all from this video, I'd appreciate it if you dropped a like on this video. If you have any questions about anything that I went over, drop them down in the comments below. Of course, if you haven't joined the family, make sure you subscribe and turn on post notifications. That way you guys get notified every time I drop a new video. Peace. See you guys in the next one.